Today I will show you how to create a classroom for teacher use in Google Classroom. Then I will show you what a student's account looks like in Google Classroom. First, open a Google browser and type in Google Classroom into the search field and click on the search icon. Google Classroom will be the first website on the list. Click on the link to go to Google Classroom. If you had not already done so, the screen will prompt you to sign in using your Gmail user identification. I'm already in there, so there's no prompt for me. Next, click on the plus sign next to your username at the top right-hand side of the screen. Then click on Create from the drop-down box if you want to create a new classroom, or Join if you have been asked to join a classroom. Many schools are using Google Classroom for grade level collaboration and district committee communications. Today we will create a classroom, so click on Create. You will need to create a class name and any description you want for this classroom. Then click on the blue Create button. Your classroom is created. Now let's look at some of the features. On the very bottom left side is your classroom code. Use this code for your students to join the class. This code can be changed if you think it's too difficult for your students to type. Just click on the drop arrow down key, and please remember to have your students type in the exact code to gain access to your Google Classroom. Now let's explore some of the features in Google Classroom in the teacher account. The center of the screen has three parts: Stream, Students, and About. Let's first take a look at Stream. This is where you would place all of the work for your students to do in Google Classroom. On the far right side at the bottom, you will see a circle with a plus sign inside. That's where you will find all the ways to create communication and lesson resources to use with Google Classroom. Let's look at each feature. The top one is Reuse a Previous Post. This is where you can reuse post. This feature lets the teacher reuse any previous assignment, question, or announcement. The next one down is Create a Question. This is where you can create a question for your students to answer based on what you are teaching or what has been taught. The next circle down in the list is Create Assignment. This is where you can create an assignment for your students. This is where you can also add additional materials to the assignment. The final circle is Create an Announcement. This is where you can send an announcement to your students. Let's look at the features of creating an assignment, since this is primarily where teachers can make assignments and lessons based on a variety of materials. So click on Create Assignment, and let's take a look at it now. When you create an assignment, you first should create a title that fits the assignment. Below that is the description where you could put in some directions or give a brief understanding of what your expectations are. Then below that is a button to create a date and time when the assignment will be due. Under the due date box are the most important features for creating assignments. There are four icons listed in a row. The first is an icon that represents locating an item from your hard drive, such as a Word document or a PDF document. The second icon looks like a Google Drive icon. This is for retrieving materials from your Google Drive. This could be a Google Doc of directions that your students can view, or a template that you can make a copy for each student. It can be a viewable spreadsheet, slide, or drawing. The most important part of this feature is how you want students to interact with the materials you are providing them. Do you want the following? Students can view the file, students can edit the file, or make a copy for each student. If you want your students to only view the document you are providing, then click on the first dropdown. The students will only be able to view the document. If you want the students to edit your original, every student will be working on the same original document. And finally, if you want each student to have their own document to work in, then click on Make a Copy for Each Student, and the assignment will provide each student with a copy of your original document to work in, and that is the one that they will submit. In addition, there is another icon, the fourth icon, for students to view a YouTube video, and finally, an icon for linking a website. To the far right of those icons is a button marked Assign. This is the button you click to send out the assignment to all of your students. Another feature of Google Classroom is the Post Question feature. That's located on the bottom right-hand side inside that circle. Let's take a look at that one. Click on Post a Question, and a box comes up for you to type your question. You can add materials to the question, like you do in assignments. However, students only have one line under the question to post their answers. In the Post a Question feature, you can also allow students to post to other students' responses, in addition to their own responses. They also may edit their own responses. I usually do not turn on the feature of posting to other students' responses in elementary grades until after we have had several practices posting and have had multiple lessons in digital citizenship, so that students understand their responses need to be academic in nature. In the post called Announcement, teachers can post an announcement to the entire class so that everyone is communicated to at the same time, the same message. In the Create an Assignment icon, teachers also have the option to add materials just as you can with assignments. You can manipulate any feature by doing the following. Move to the top, edit, or delete any of the posts, assignments, or announcements. There are three circles to the far right side of the title. Click on that and you will see a drop-down menu. It says move to the top, edit, or delete. You can make any changes and the students will need to refresh to see those new changes or delete it and it's no longer available for students. You can reuse any of the questions, assignments, or announcements by clicking on the Reuse button and choosing the one you would like to reuse. Just remember to change the due dates. Finally, you can look at specific entries students have done in their Google Classroom assignments by clicking on the Students feature at the top of your screen. It's located between Stream and About in the main portion of your Google Classroom. If you don't see it, go to the top left corner of your Google Classroom page and click on the arrow back. The About feature lets you tell your students a little about yourself, how they can get in contact with you, and your email so that they can contact you. along with a link to the calendar where they can see what's due. When you create any post, assignment, or announcement, it will be the very top item inside Google Classroom that your students see. They go in descending order from the last created at the bottom to the most recent created at the top, but you can reposition them using the Move to Top button located inside the three dots to the right side of the title. Now let's take a quick look at what a student sees when they log on to Google Classroom. Students will log on to Google Classroom the same way you did, and to the left of their name is a plus sign. Then they click on to join and enter the classroom code to join your class. Once they have joined your classroom, they will be featured in the body of the Google Classroom page. They may belong to more than one Google Classroom, so please make sure they are clicking on the correct classroom to look for your materials. A student sees the same three titles at the top: Stream, Classmates, and About. All the same features as a teacher's account. Please note, depending upon your school district policies, students' email features may be turned off. That means that they can send only adults in the district an email. However, they will not be able to send emails to other students. In grades 3 through 12, email is turned on for our district, but in the lower grades, it is turned off. In the About section is where students can find a link to communicate to their teacher and see the calendar feature for their Google Classroom assignments. The Stream feature is where students can locate any assignments, posts, or announcements created by their teacher. In the Stream feature, students click on the Open button on the far right side to open their assignment and read directions. This is where they would also need to click on any additional materials to view and manipulate those materials provided by their teacher. This is also where they can submit when they're finished. After students have used the materials, their teacher may want them to submit their document back to her for grading and review. Note, this is where they would also need to keep due dates in mind. The Classmates section allows students to see each of the students inside their class, and if the district allows it, they can send emails to classmates. Students also have a circle located at the bottom right, but the only feature they have available is to create a post. These are the features that are inside Google Classroom for teachers and students. It is a very useful tool for teachers and can provide opportunities for students to work in a platform that requires less paper and less opportunities for lost work. I hope you have enjoyed this overview of Google Classroom. Please email me, Linda Froelich at vistausd.org, if you have any questions. Thanks.